Hey, everyone. Great job on the karaoke stuff last week. It was awesome hearing you sing some new songs I was familiar with and hearing some songs that were new to me. This week, I'm excited to return to another new mystery of why there's this guy climbing on the wall next to me. At least he has a friend. Okay, so another new mystery. In the past, we've looked at how sound happens different ways with different items you find in your kitchen. Glasses that are full of water sound different than the same glass with less water. And there are different ways to make sound with these objects. But was anyone curious why this happened? The sound produced from our finger on the rim of the wine glass actually moved the water. In certain circumstances, you can even feel the sounds. Maybe you felt this when a loud car drives by or you turn speakers up really loud. But don't do this. It's not good for your ears to hear such loud things. In this project, we're going to investigate how sound turns from something you hear into something you can see. For this experiment, you will need a bowl, some stretchy plastic saran wrap or something similar you can pull tight. Rubber band. I use a couple. Something small and grainy. Baking sprinkles would work great, large pepper flakes, or some really small rice. If you're curious about something and not sure if it'll work, give it a try. I use quinoa seeds. They're kind of like rice, but they're a very small seed. Next, we need to put a rubber band around the whole bowl. The bigger the bowl, the better this experiment works. My problem was, while the bowl was huge, all my rubber bands were too small. But never fear, your music teacher is creative. Bonus points if you can be creative too, and exercise that creative muscle of yours by problem solving it. When you run into a problem, think, that is an opportunity to build your creative muscles by solving it. Here was my solution. I took a few paper clips to attach a few rubber bands together, and that way it's big enough for the bowl. What problem will you run into, and how will you solve it? The next step is spreading the saran wrap, stretching it tight, and getting it all across the bowl. Now you want to make sure it's really tight, and all the edges are even. So try stretching it out first, and afterwards securing the rubber band. If you want to pull it tight down in a couple different areas after you put in the rubber band, that is A-OK too. Now that my whole bowl experiment is set up, it's time to run this experiment. I'll pour some quinoa seeds onto the saran wrap. These are delicious. And then I begin. I begin by humming into the bowl. I'll hum low and I'll hum high, loud and soft, and in all sorts of different ways. Depending on how your bowl is set up, each bowl will like a different type of humming. It looks like my bowl likes lower and louder humming. Most bowls like louder humming. Make sure not to blow on it like I did. Then your quinoa seeds get everywhere. After I did the initial experiment, I was super curious. I thought, what if I change some of the things in this experiment? What if instead of humming, I hit a pan lid? Turns out, I still got the seeds to move, but less than the humming. What if I use something even louder? Ha! The seeds move even more. I think quinoa seeds really like my tuba playing. I am super impressed when I have curious students. How can you customize your experiment to fit what you are curious about? Maybe you use a different size bowl, or make a saran wrap looser, or maybe use different things than saran wrap. Maybe you'll use salt, or cooking sprinkles, or anything else instead of the quinoa seeds I used. Maybe you'll even play an instrument into the bowl, too. Question I've got. Why in the world do things on the bowl move when you make sound? Write down a guess as to why you think it vibrates and the things move. After you write it down, do some research. Ask a parent. Ask an older sibling. Ask another friend from class through Seesaw. I've been really impressed with a few very clever students who even research previous mysteries online also. I like to write down my first guess and then do some research and see how close I was, or more often, how wrong I was, and then find out how the real answer is different. I loved the karaoke stuff last week. I'm looking forward to seeing what awesome stuff you put together this week. Bye-bye!